let's see if Change My Mind is able to keep on track with only three members.
Yep, no surprises here. This is the main competition from Never Lucky. It's what got them to the spring finals in the first place. Change My Mind, you know, limited options. We'll be running that Assassination Shadow Priest once again, hoping to channel a little bit of, you know, the peekaboo Wiz K, the move, as they say. Change My Mind, they will get the opener over onto Zach, the kidney shots. It will come down to, you know, we've had a couple of discussions this tournament. Who are the best Windwalkers here? Because it is very topical. You know, Chun-Li already showing how great he can be. Can Zach keep up pace? He'll need to if they are to win this series.
Yeah, certainly. I'm trying to take a look at the gearing Zach has available. So far, everything's pretty standard. He's going to be going with that triple impassive visage for a little bit of extra healing when he is tunneled down. So far, good pressure for Never Lucky onto Valet, but Valet has been able to stall out the game for quite some time. Zach could be in a little bit of trouble, throwing out a Fist of Fury, looking for some damage. This is the first crowd control attempt by Change My Mind, but it's Valet once again on the back foot. Polo now caught into a sap. What is Zach going to do? Actually using his portal to kite away early on. That way Kolo doesn't really have to play catch-up. He can just escape, pop himself off. And I think as long as Zach is doing a really good job keeping his portal in a good position, then I think he can survive. But I think right now you can see his transcendence is caught into the midfield. And a mistake like that is something that Change My Mind can really capitalize on.
Yeah, I really hope that maybe it's Kolo's and he could port on top of him, but it most likely is Zach. So that could be definitely a mistake to look out for when he's trying to kite later on in this game. Touch of Karma used very early on by Zach as well. The Touch of Karma and the Diffuse Magic are down. Kolo isn't actually running the Relentless either, and he trades out his trinket. So that means there's a big opening, I would say, for Change My Mind in this situation. A lot of those defensive cooldowns are down. Mpoike's been doing a fantastic job. He's been spamming out solo rafts, just trying to aid his team offensively in any way he can. And this next offensive push could be really scary for Never Lucky.
Yeah, definitely could be. We'll have to see exactly what happens. There's a full kidney shot on to Zach. Is he going to be able to escape without that transcendence? It's going to be really scary.
Ports
in the midfield once again. Flying Serpent kick away. These are mistakes he cannot afford to make. Vortex keeping Zach locked down. Acro looking to take him down. Cycling onto Kolo. Zach caught all by himself, but I think he should be able to survive once again. His portal's in midfield. He needs to relay it. Finally does. I think Zach may be feeling a little bit of nerves in this matchup.
Yeah, Zach needs a few hours of double monk TB2, if you ask me. He's definitely showing little signs of nerve here and there. Of course, this guy is only 17-year-old. It's the first time he's attended one of these LAN events, so we're expecting big things of him. You know, we're asking questions like, is he the next Trill, you know? Like that is the kind of pressure we're putting on him.
Whoa!
As Vilai gets chunked, has to use his dispersion before the Touch of Death. Could potentially be an opening for Change My Mind. And Never Lucky, honestly, they did kind of get away with that error. They have the Diffuse back, Touch of Karma as well. And they're starting to take, you know, I actually think they have a little bit more pressure than the boys did when this matchup was played last time.
Yeah, things are actually looking really good here for Never Lucky. As long as Zach can survive, Lito and Kolo can back him out. A beautiful double ring apiece, keeping Valet up in the air like a volleyball, styling on Change My Mind just a little bit. If you look at mana, and Poike behind, when we saw them go up against the boys, he was able to sneak away for a few drinks. We'll have to see if Never Lucky can shut that down or if they even care. Valet getting low with no dispersion. This could be the life swap, trying to get away with just a fade. Maledic soaking up a lot of that incoming healing as Mpoike sits down for a drink. A little bit of greedy plays here, but I changed my mind. But Mpoike not playing it too greedy. Stops his drink, gets the iron bark, and ultimately Valet will survive.
Yeah, that was a good in-between there from Mpoike. He didn't go for the full mana drink because Touch of Death was on Vilai. He knew that he would have to trade out Life Swap effectively if he had gone for more mana there. Vilai, though, still a little bit low, does have that Vampiric Embrace healing himself up. Mpoike did exchange his trinket for the drink as well, but I think that was a perfectly reasonable trade. As I said, holding on to that Life Swap, the big defensive cooldown that it's a five-minute cooldown, you know, they don't want to have to use it too early in this game. Vilai still taking so much pressure, and the fact that Never Lucky just seemingly have more damage than the boys does means that Change My Mind is struggling to get offensive. You know, Vilai's scared to cast Shadow when he's low health because he can't access his defensive arsenal. And because of that, you know, I think we're seeing less pressure coming out of Change My Mind in this game. This matchup, from Never Lucky, the way they're playing it, makes it look even more one-sided than it did before.
Yeah, definitely a difficult matchup for Change My Mind. Dispersion really low from Vilai. And Poike has to play catch-up, not committing the Iron Bark just yet. Vilai manages to get away with it. Here's a sap on Nicolo. Good croc control chain by Change My Mind, but they just can't find the damage. Zach hasn't really had to run away. Outside of the first few moments of the game, there hasn't been much pressure onto Never Lucky. Polo's been doing a great job just sitting back, keeping him alive quite easily. Now a double leg sweep set up here from Never Lucky. Triple leg sweep. Nice communication, nice coordination by Never Lucky as Vilai gets lower and lower.
Yeah, he's under so much pressure. He's going to try out the Void Shift here, surely. So low, there it is. Over onto Minpoke, that 5-minute cooldown forced out. One question I wanted to ask you, my Mistweaver friend, Venfuki. Why do you not think the Diffuse Magic's being played by Kolo? Because obviously they're playing the Mind Bomb. Couldn't they just reverse one of those kind of silence Mind Bomb setups every 1.5 minutes? Or do you think, you know, just playing the Healing Elixir is better?
I'm not sure. The Healing Elixir provides a lot of self-healing if they are going to make swaps over onto Kolo. The most interesting thing about Kolo's build I've noticed is he's actually not playing the Counteract Magic. He's playing Healing Sphere. He's going to be able to throw down the Healing Spheres and dispel a lot of the damage Filet has available. When he does go into those extended crowd control chains, you can see those little orbs on the ground. Run into one of those. So although Filet and Acro, they have long crowd control, if every time they get crowd control, they just walk into one of the spheres, all of a sudden all of Filet's pressure is completely gone. And I think this is one of those adaptations, one of those talents Never Lucky would certainly bring to the battle, and it seems really good in this particular matchup.
That's a very Kolo talent, and that's a really good pick from you, because, I mean, that's actually probably the main reason why changed my mind of struggling so much to generate pressure here. I was saying that part of it is the fact Never Lucky have seemingly so much more pressure, but if every single time Change My Mind go for an offensive push, Zac can sidestep and remove all of the dot damage from Vili, that is huge. And maybe, you know, that's one of those things where Kolo has just found something. Vili has died, and Never Lucky, you know, I love watching Kolo, right?
He's not afraid to take that spot and going to try to take a win.
Yep, Zac with that Windwalker Monk. We kind of talked about how on the Holy Paladin, you can negate that touch of karma. So as a Windwalker Monk in this particular matchup, you have to change the way you rotate your defensive cooldowns. Touch of karma has to be something you use very early on. If you're going to get pressure down, as soon as your healer goes into crowd control, you use your touch of karma. That way, if it gets, you know, Blessing and Protection off or it gets Divine Shield off, you still have all your other defenses that you can utilize and sort of rotate through, and you don't fall as susceptible to some of these all-ins that the Holy Paladin teams have available.
I actually love this pick from Minpoke. I think, firstly, the big thing is that the Paladin has less healing, so they will die faster. Like, the Resto Druid obviously has the biggest throughput healing. It's one of the reasons it's the most powerful healer in the current meta, a lot of people would say. But the Holy Paladin brings the offense. Clearly they were struggling with that last game. You mentioned the Blessing of Protection for the Touch of Karma, nullifying that cooldown. What the Holy Paladin also brings, in addition to the Mind Bomb, which is on Fear DR, he's also playing the Repentance talent, which is on the Polymorph DR. So they basically have the kind of Mage Shadow Priest crowd control, but the Paladin is replacing Fried Kitty. Minpoke trying to channel that. You see he's playing aggressively, trying to get those repentances off. That's kind of the game plan here. Valido, though, reads the situation. He knows it, and he denies it with the Mind Freeze. Good play from him.
Yeah, unfortunately for Acro, he went for the Vanish Sap out of the Mind Bomb, but Kolo was in combat. He wasn't able to find it, and he kind of wasted that Vanish. Vendetta not really able to get too much work done, and Zac able to easily survive. And like we kind of talked about, for Change My Mind, bringing in a Holy Paladin, it's unlikely they can extend the game as long with that with the Restoration Druid. So they're on the clock. They have to find the crowd control. They have to find the burst damage. Here, a nice little attempt onto Zac right now. Kidney Shot into Cheap Shot. Silence on Kolo. He can't wait too long. Blessing of Protection gets used on the Touch of Karma. Now Zac's in a little bit of trouble, but Kolo in a great position. Very far away, able to top off Zac. And right now, Never Lucky, they're looking good.
I mean, to be honest, like, it's an interesting one, right? Because the Paladin is a bold move from Minpoke, but it's a bold move when they're up against it. They have no real other options. And that setup was actually really good. They got the trinket. They got the trinket from Kolo in addition to the Touch of Karma. So big cooldowns being forced, even though they didn't necessarily get the best Vanish earlier in the game. Acro will have his Vanish back up before Kolo has his trinket, meaning they could set up another one of these kind of silence into Mind Bomb, into Sap setups on Zac, and they'll still have a second Blessing of Protection to set up and kill through the Touch of Karma. That's what they've got to be playing for. I'd love to see Minpoke saving his Avenging Wrath for that as well, because Paladins with that Avenging Wrath can do, you know, judgments up to 30, 40k. They can really contribute damage, and this is going to have to be an all-in if Change My Mind out to pick up the game.
Yeah, Acro struggling to find pressure. Actually made a little bit of a mistake. He uses Mark for Death Kidney Shot onto Zac, but unfortunately he was still on Diminishing Return, so it was only a 2-second stun, and they weren't able to get any pressure rolling because of that. Double Life Sweep coming in from Zac. Good damage onto Valet and Acro. You can see Never Lucky, they're implementing a split strategy. Valido, he knows Minpoke is playing Repentance. He wants to deny that, so he's sitting on him. Colo now caught into a silence. I think they actually broke the blind. So that's a lot of crowd control. Big mistakes coming in from Change My Mind.
That's a game changer. That blind was the kill go. You see the Avenging Wrath from Mimpoike, the Vendetta from AcroLols. The blind breaks. That's GG. I mean, honestly, that's probably the worst thing that could have happened for them. Unlucky, maybe never lucky, sometimes lucky there. Colo now with the Way of the Crane pushing in. Now they know that they have survived the big onslaught. They were playing carefully. You can see they were kind of line of sighting, uncertain about their future. Now they can push in with certainty. They're attacking Mimpoike on the Paladin. He used the Avenging Wrath offensively, so he will not have that defensively, and they're pushing for the Divine Shield.
Yeah, Mimpoike getting low. Divine Shield gets traded out, and things are spiraling out of control for Change My Mind. They have to basically play perfect at this point, but I don't know what opportunities there really are. Finally, Repentance gets snuck in onto Colo into a sap. Zac getting low. If he waits too long on the Touch of Karma, they could just push through. Silence into Mind Bomb. What is Colo going to do? Saving his Trinket. He still has the Life Cocoon. Zac just holding on to the Touch of Karma. Life Cocoon finally gets traded out, and I think Zac should be able to survive. Nice Mind Control, but that gets shut down by Valido. Good backup, freeing up his team. And you can see Mimpoike, they're running out of cooldowns. They're running out of mana. They are running out of time.
Yeah, it's definitely not looking good for them. But again, another good sign of life from Change My Mind, but the cooldowns are rotating on Never Lucky. They didn't even force the second, the Touch of Karma for the second Blessing of Protection there. So Zac holding onto those cooldowns, a little bit greedy, but again, showing confidence. You know, the 17-year-old, his first LAN event, not getting nervous under the pressure. And these teams are really trying to be applying the pressure to him. Vilai now definitely taking the brunt of the exchange. Avenging Wrath up in about 10 seconds from Mimpoike. I would like to say that's the last chance they really have in this game, is surviving to that. But like you mentioned, the blue bar from Mimpoike, that mana resource which he's using for the healing, is almost depleted. You've got the dispersion down on Vilai. It's really not looking good for this three-man roster from Europe. There's a good chance they'll be going home.
Yeah, this is looking disastrous, but Zac could still potentially go down. He has no Trinket, although he has a Touch of Karma. And Foyke, unfortunately, doesn't have a Blessing of Protection to remove it. Cole is just going to be trading out the Life Cocoon on some of that crowd control, and that's going to allow Zac to get super aggressive. Still a split strategy. Mimpoike barely holding on with his Avenging Wrath. Does manage to top himself off. He needs to find some healing on Valet. Double Leg Sweep coming in from Zac, just cleaving down both Valet and Acro, punishing them for attacking him. There's a full kidney shot with a blind on Colo. Colo not messing around this time. He Trinkets out, wants to keep Zac full HP, keep him aggressive in this match because they know it's only a matter of time.
Yeah, Colo's been playing actually very aggressively. He trades out his Trinket for the blind there. He's been using his mana just to make sure that Zac is topped off because he wants him to feel confident to push for this kill. He knows that against the Paladin, you will have more offensive pressure. As we can see right now, Mimpoike, once again, that Avenging Wrath has expired. There's no defensive cooldowns really available after that Greater Fade. One more connection over onto Vilai with the Touch of Death, which is up in about 10 seconds. Should secure the match. They just need to survive that long. Zac, you know, he has the Touch of Karma, he has the Diffuse Magic. Going to trade out one of those cooldowns. And, I mean, the last Blessing of Protection is still available. Maybe they can get some pressure here. They're looking for the Repentance. Good grip coming in from Valido. They still land it, though. Zac on the run. This could be the last chance.
Yep, Zac behind the little cart across the map in the ooze. Now into a full kidney shot. He's out of line of sight. Colo gets there quickly with the Chi Torpedo, manages to connect the Life Cocoon, and now Change My Mind, although they were able to get a lot of defensive cooldown there. Actually, Never Lucky is a little bit vulnerable. If Change My Mind can hold on just a little bit longer, they might be able to push through and take down Zac. Colo with no Life Cocoon, Zac with no defensive cooldowns really available. It really is going to be up to Zac to make sure he can kite around, stall, and just allow Valido to slowly but surely take down Mimpoike.
That was kind of like a split offense there. It looked like Zac wanted to use the Touch of Death over onto Vilai, but Valido really wanted to chase after Mimpoike.
Oh no!
Now they're in a bit of trouble. Zac retreating behind the pit. Doesn't use the Diffuse Magic here even. He's trying to use the line of sight to his advantage. A good portal positioning with that Transcendence, meaning that he will stay alive. Now Colo out of crowd control. He's almost out of his mana bar as well, but the pressure definitely in favor of Never Lucky. Mimpoike dropping low. Valido's been chasing him, and I actually really like that strategy, denying the repentances. I think we've only seen one or two in the whole game, so the Death Knight doing a fantastic job of denying Change My Mind, and the split strategy's been looking pretty good for them. The Maledict's coming in. Mimpoike doing a fantastic job, but I mean, it's looking dire.
That was a nice Divine Favor heal right on the leg sweep, full blind on Valido. Zac could still be in some trouble. He has a Touch of Karma. If he can just hold on a little bit longer, they can make the final push on him. And Poike, there's a full kidney shot. And I think at this point in the game, Valido and Zac, they can coordinate their efforts on him. And Poike, he's got no Avenging Wrath. Blessing of Protection gets traded out on the Karma. Mind Bomb on Colo. Things are horrible right now for Change My Mind. If they pull this off, it's going to be a miracle. Zac trying to survive with the Diffused Magic, with the Fortifying Brew, Fist of Fury to avoid some damage. Colo running in, dispelling him, trying to keep him alive, but there's no Life Cocoon. The Maledict lands. Change My Mind, can they do the impossible?
No way.
Zac still just barely holding on. Empoike chasing him down, trying to take him down. Beautiful paralysis. Zach hiding around, but Change My Mind have done it, putting a point on the board. That looked completely hopeless for them, but they stayed calm, cool, and collected.
Sounds like maybe people will be a bit easier to, you know, use the Divine Shield at 30%, but actually killing someone, you've got to do that last point of damage, you know, and people will do anything in their power to stop you.
That is true. Have to see what exactly gets down in this game. Change My Mind, implementing their Holy Paladin, trying to really exploit the fact that Zach is on the Windwalker Monk, and he really relies on that Touch of Karma. If they can remove that with the Blessing and Protection with the Divine Shield, that makes Zach a lot more vulnerable in this match. But you can see Change My Mind. They've found their groove. They're going to be moving in, trying to get aggressive onto Zach early on. Sap now onto Kolo. Is he going to Trinket? What is he going to do? Zach, Blessing and Protection gets traded out immediately on that Touch of Karma, and he's on the run. Maladic gets traded out, Fortifying Brew as well as the Diffuse Magic. Zach manages to hold on, but at the expense of basically all his defensive cooldowns.
You know, I said I don't believe in Change My Mind, but I mean, Liverpool 4-0 Barcelona earlier in the week. I think maybe Villa can come up with something. This guy is an absolute beast when it comes to lands.
Which arena tournament was that?
I don't recall, but at the first, I mean, at first-hand experience, I can tell you that Villa is an absolute monster at these lands, and he is showing up here, Mimpoike as well, like, their offense is on point, they're trying to hold on to the Divine Shield here, they should be able to with that Avenging Wrath, good Duke over on the Mind Freeze, Mind Control's coming out. Actually, Trinketed from Valido. I'm not sure I like that Trinket, to be honest, because he's the main person stopping the Repentances. If they can get some cross crowd control later in this game, Repentances will keep coming out from Mimpoike, and the defense actually has been much worse from Neverlucky in the start of this second, or this third game, rather, here on Tiger's Peak, or Asher Mains. God, it's been a long day. But Asher Mains full here. Kolo's been tanking a lot of these Repentances on the bigger map because of the open spaces. And, I mean, if Mimpoike can keep landing these, they can get the cross kidney shots onto Zach. They're going to force him to run more. And the pressure from Neverlucky in this game has been much less than we saw in the game two.
Yeah, I think Neverlucky, they could be playing a little bit scared in this matchup, although bringing it to Ashmain's Fall is a bigger playground for a Windwalker Monk like Zach to use that Transcendence, use the Flying Serpent Kick and Rolls to really just navigate around the map, and it's easier when you have these big pillars like the one Zach's at right now to get away. It's more difficult for Valet and Acro to really push in, especially when you have Valido backing him up with Chains of Ice on Acro, and Valet can Death Grip Valet back when he's pushing in for that final little bit of damage. And I think this is what I really want to see. Zach, when he is not being tunneled down and he's safe, this is when you get aggressive on him. Mimpoike, you back up Valido. He can consistently sit on top of Mimpoike, but when Zach comes and backs him up, that's when they can land the stuns and they can try to get those big defensive cooldowns out.
Yeah, I think it's something that we'll have to watch for. But Zach, I mean, yeah, yes, the map is great for him defensively, right? Like, there's been a bunch of times where Kolo's been caught in crowd control, and then we've seen Zach, you know, pull away. But it's like I was talking about in the previous series against the boys for Change My Mind. Every single time that Zach runs away, he's not dealing damage. Mimpoike's not using mana, and they're starting to swap the damage over onto Valido. And the Death Knight is also a viable kill target here. They forced a fair few cooldowns there, the anti-magic shell coming out, for example. Now we see mind controls from Villai. And honestly, this team's just starting to take over with crowd control here. Change My Mind. They're looking as if they're playing Rogue Mage or something. This is Shadow Priest Paladin.
Yeah, there's a full Repentance on Nicolo. What are they going to do? Valido caught into a full stun. Can they really take Valido down? He preemptively dropped the anti-magic zone on that kidney shot. Very excellently done. Kolo has been crowd controlled, which seems like forever. Gladiator, Safeguard, procs. I did not expect him to be able to take down Valido. That is going to be the Life Cocoon traded up from Kolo as well as his Trinket. Change My Mind has overwhelming pressure in this game, and Neverlucky, they're just playing scared.
Yeah, they need to play to the script more. The anti-magic zone was great, but it was after the Vendetta as well. So the next Vendetta, there's going to be no Trinket for Kolo, no anti-magic zone. If they can force like a couple more of these next goes, you know, get the Trinket, for example, from Valido here, as well as the anti-magic shell, I could easily see that next Vendetta coming up in about a minute being lethal for Change My Mind. That said, I don't want them to fall into the trap they did against the boys, where they let Zach be free, have a lot of uptime, because that could be really scary for them. I want them to keep kind of splitting up this damage, putting pressure on Zach, forcing him to run away, and then using the off damage over onto Valido. Meanwhile, though, Mimpoike sitting down for drinks. This is a completely different game from the last one.
Do you feel like this map is sort of backfired?
Yeah,
on
it looks like it, doesn't it?
Yeah, Ruins of Lordaeron allowed Valido much higher uptime on Mimpoike. Wasn't nearly as scary for Zach to reconnect to his target. He could get across the map quite quickly, but on this map, seems like if he's using all his mobility across the map, Mimpoike can easily sort of divide their team by overextending Valido. And now, this is a completely different game when Mimpoike can actually afford to sit down and get mana.
Yeah, I mean, it's weird, right? Because changed my mind, ended up choosing the map which almost was their poison, the small map. And it makes sense, right? Because they want to be really aggressive this Paladin pick as we see this, once again, the Blessing and Protection coming out onto Zac. I love the fact they've swapped it over. The Blind is unfortunately DR'd, but they get the sap anyways. Huge plays coming in from Acro, and this could be it for Zac. Fist of Fury desperately running into Vili, though. Maledict's coming in, the Life Cocoon from Kolo. Maybe if that Blind hadn't been DR, they might have got the kill there. I think it was off the Mind Bomb. Maybe they could have waited a little bit. They looked for the opportunity, didn't quite manage to land it. But, I mean, the bigger map definitely not paying out for Neverlucky right now. They're struggling with pressure, Avenging Wrath from Mpoike, and Zac, with very low cooldowns, could be a kill target in the near future.
Yeah, we definitely have to give credit to Mpoike in this matchup. Sometimes we criticize his alts besides the Restoration Druid, but he's been doing a really good job on this Holy Paladin. This is the reason why his team has been able to stay in this series so far. So kudos to him, and kudos to Change My Mind for making this a well-fought series. We are tied 1-1 in the lower bracket. The loser of the series will be completely eliminated from the tournament. So obviously a lot on the line. Tensions are high. Right now it seems like Neverlucky, they're playing a little bit scared. They're trying to, they're struggling to really find momentum, but this is a really nice swap onto Acro. Hopefully Acro will be able to survive, manages to get the Shadow Mail, the re-stealth, the Sheep Shot on the multiple members into a full kitty shot onto Valido. Now Valido under fire, forced to retreat behind the pillar, but it is unlikely at this point of the game the Death Knight really falls down unless Change My Mind can find overwhelming damage.
To be honest, maybe Neverlucky can actually just afford to play a really defensive game on a big map here, because Mpoike on the Paladin will struggle. Just like I said, the healing output from the Paladin versus the Druid is less. So maybe it's fine for Change My Mind, or fine for Neverlucky, sorry, against Change My Mind, to just kind of play this defensive game. But they need to do a better job then of stopping these repentances, because Mpoike has had kind of free reign on Kolo. Kolo keeps getting caught out in the middle, you know. They don't have Valido on Mpoike to deny it. And one of these repentances is going to be lethal eventually. We see a triple stun coming in, good grip, and now the Fade going to be forced out from Vili. Does have that dispersion available, but the mana game heavily favoring Neverlucky. And honestly, like, I feel like the offense from Change My Mind is over time reducing right now. They need to find something to get it going. But as I say that, huge damage onto Zac.
Yeah, kidney shot on Zac, fortifying brew, overlap with his trinket, with the life cocoon from Kolo. A little bit of damage can be found on Kolo as well. And I think for Neverlucky, just keeping it simple, sit on Valet, try to limit his damage, use the healing spheres if Kolo is still using that as a talent choice, he is. So just try to limit as much damage as possible, like we saw in game number one. And eventually the Windwalker Death Knight damage, it can overwhelm, but splitting targets, trying to go after the rogue, it just doesn't seem to be working out. Acro is a little bit low right now, but he does have the trinket and banish. That's basically a free get out of jail free card whenever he needs it. And Change My Mind will manage to hold on. If you look at mana, still Neverlucky has the lead. And I have to agree with you, if they can just hold on, they can play it safe, play it passive. The Windwalker Monk cooldowns, the Mistweaver Monk cooldowns, they are very short. So if they can just get away for a little bit of time, all those cooldowns rotate back up, and they can make very favorable trades against Change My Mind.
Yeah, and this is a big, big trade for Neverlucky right now. They forced the Vanish out of Acro defensively, meaning there won't be any follow-up sap on this Mind Bomb. That could have been potential for a huge offensive play. We see the Bomb also coming out defensively now. The Divine, or the Avenging Wrath from Mpoike, all of these cooldowns that can be used either defensively or offensively are being forced by Neverlucky, meaning they have more momentum. They can afford to be the aggressive team right now. Divine Shield also forced out on Mpoike. And, I mean, game two was really close, and it ended up being one of those situations where the outplay, you know, the Hodge on the trinket was the game-winning play. But once again here, Neverlucky are looking better and better. If they can just play it cautiously, you know, make sure that they account for the fact that the Blessing and Protection is still available for the hand of, for the Touch of Karma, I feel like they should have this one, though.
Yeah, Acro still in some trouble. No feint, no cooldowns. He's trying to use evasive maneuvers, shadow stepping over to Valet. Never going to be able to get a re-stealth really in this matchup. And when Zac and Valido reconnect, it's going to be danger time. There's a full kidney shot onto Valido. Blessing Protection gets traded out by Acro. That means Zac's going to be super safe. I can't help but feel like maybe Change My Mind is wasting too much time on Valido. They got him low early on in the game, and it might have been sort of a bait from Neverlucky. Now Neverlucky, they're looking really healthy. Death Knights are hard to take down. Double leg sweep coming in. Void Shift gets traded out by Valet. Change My Mind is running out of cooldowns.
Yeah, I think this is the bait. This is what I said. They're falling under so much pressure because they're not targeting Zac. They need to target Zac, force him to use that Transcendence Port away so that they can stay stable and use stuff offensively. That said, Valido is taking a lot of damage right now. We see the Trinket on the Blind from Kolo, the Anti-Magic Zone exchanged for the Vendetta, but a nice Mind Control is unable to be interrupted here. There comes the Repentance.
This could potentially be game.
Yeah, Felito getting low. Lele trying to take him down. Sap now on to Cola. Garrote silence on Felito.
And
change my mind. Go up in this series. Unbelievable. I didn't think going after the Death Knight would be the best strategy, but they
don't want to win the tournament, potentially sending them home. And then also, then Ricky, were you about to say it would be a revenge match if he went up against ABC, right?
I don't think so, but sure, it would be a great revenge match.
What were you going to say?
I was going to say that I feel like Never Lucky should stick to their guns. Like, in game number two, they did a split strategy. In game number three, they went after Acro. Why don't they just sit on Valet once again? Yeah. Like, just sit on Valet. When Poike pushes in for repentances, that's when you use your paralysis, you use your Ring of Peace from Zac to try to deny some of that crowd control, and you can really limit the damage the Shadow Priest can put out, and that's where Never Lucky kind of hit their stride in game one.
Yeah, I completely agree. Like, Valet had a lot of control over the last game. He was spamming mind controls.
Whoa.
In fact, at the end of the game, it was game-winning mind controls coming in on the anti-magic zone from Valet. They need to have at least one melee sitting on him. This guy will pop off if you give him the opportunity. That said, Never Lucky with basically the ideal opener here. They get the Divine Shield from Minpoike with a good offensive push. Didn't even commit the Touch of Death. And maybe if Minpoike has to play this aggressive for the team to win the match, punishing him could well be the answer, but I don't think it's accurate. I agree.
This is good for Zac, though. They got the Divine Shield. Forbearance on Minpoike means he can't use the Blessing and Protection on that Touch of Karma, and Zac can get very aggressive, hitting a Blessing and Protection on that touch of death. Now Minpoike in a situation, no Divine Shield, no Avenging Wrath, no touch of basically anything, doesn't have many cooldowns left. Never Lucky can get aggressive if they need to in this situation. I think on the smaller map, Minpoike is actually a great target.
Yeah, they're actually swapping some damage over onto Kolo here. I'm not 100% convinced about this. I think it's definitely something that you will see Rogue Shadow Priest trying to do because, you know, you've got the stun lock, you got a lot of damage, but I think it's better served attacking Zac or Valido. Yes, there's a chance you get the kill on Kolo. Maybe he messes up, doesn't trinket, or, you know, trinkets too late, but you stop more damage by also applying your kidney shots and your crowd control in general to the DPS, forcing them to play defensively. Tunneling Minpoike is looking very good for Never Lucky right now. On this small map, Villay coming, you know, use Life Grip, Leap of Faith very effectively. He's struggling to help too much. He's using the Mind Bombs defensively as well, which is, it's going pretty good for Never Lucky, I want to say. They're winning the mana very slightly. It's pretty even at this point. But more importantly, Minpoike can't land those repentances, which is what Changed My Mind had as kind of their key to victory.
Nice double leg sweep onto Acro and Valet while Minpoike is getting trained down. Minpoike is still in a lot of trouble. You can see Zac, he has the Touch of Garma. He has the cooldowns that he needs to run him down, and I can't think of a better Windwalker monk to train down a Paladin and know their weaknesses than Zac. So Minpoike gets lower and lower. They're just shredding through. Valet forced to trade out that Void Shift. And now, Change My Mind into a position where they don't have many cooldowns to work with. They might make a swap on a Valet, force a dispersion, but seems like Minpoike still is the choice target for Never Lucky.
Yep, they're just tunneling him down, and it's working very well. Avenging Wrath now available for Minpoike. I think this is a case of, you know, when in doubt, tunnel Minpoike. They're attacking him a lot here. Holy Light coming in with that Avenging Crusader will be enough to stabilize. Second Blessing of Protection used, though, means there won't be any left for the future Touch of Karmas, so Zac should be looking very, very safe at this point in the game. The real test being put here to Minpoike on that Paladin, this is the hardest thing you can deal with as a Paladin, is being tunneled by two melees. And honestly, Change My Mind, the offense hasn't looked that good. They're trying to swap it over to Kolo once again here, but I mean, without those repentances, the Paladin really doesn't bring that much benefit offensively.
No, Kolo can use the Healing Spheres to remove the Vampiric Touch from Valet, as well as the Shadow Word Pain, without actually being put into that Vampiric Touch horror effect. So it's a good denial there by Kolo. And Minpoike, like we kind of talked about, he's got no trinket, he's got no defensive cooldowns. Valet really doesn't have any backup for him. If Zac and Valido can stay on target, they will take him down. But Zac a little bit vulnerable here with no Touch of Karma for another 15 seconds. This is an opportunity for Change My Mind. Kolo doesn't have many defenses, his mana isn't looking great. Never Lucky has sort of went for an all-in. This could be it on Minpoike, though.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those situations where actually Tony Minpoike is the most mana-efficient thing for him because he can't heal as much. So he's got a mana lead as a result of it. Oh, a beautiful knock into the eye. He can't do any healing. Excellent Ring of Peace coming in there from Never Lucky, denying the heals from Minpoike, but he's doing a stellar job keeping himself alive. I think I've seen him interrupted like once or twice in this entire game. He's doing a good job,
That's
but the
all.
Full stun comes through. It's surely going to be enough. The DR stun, Minpoike is so low on health, and he does end up falling 2-2. We're going to game five.
3-0. We're finally getting down to the wire. One game going to decide who stays in the tournament and who gets sent all the way back home. Is it going to be Change My Mind or Never Lucky? We find out right now.
Game 5 here on the sands of Tolvaron Arena. Kolo and Neverlucky, the upcomer. We had them painted as the David versus the Goliath of Mever Black, but how far they've come throughout this tournament and quite frankly throughout this season. New names that we will see time again throughout 2019 against the veterans. Changed my mind without Fried Kitty having an absolute stellar performance here. And I mean, one more game and they go through the Sunday.
Yeah, once again, it looks like they're going to be trying to implement a strategy where they run down Npoike. Npoike with the Divine Steed just being ran into that Ring of Peace. Unfortunately, Valet is able to back him up with that Leap of Faith, and Npoike gets behind the pillar. Now Zac caught in midfield, a little bit vulnerable right now. Really not able to get too much damage off with that Stormwrath and Fire. Here's what I'm talking about. On this larger map, I think it's going to be much more difficult for Neverlucky to actually force out a lot of these defensive cooldowns. You can see Npoike has made some adaptations, and his trinket choice is going to be playing Relentless instead of the Gladiator's Medallion, so that way every one of these stuns is going to be reduced. Zac though in a lot of trouble. Touch of Karma does get Busking Protection off, and
no way.
It looks like Change My Mind just want to close it out early on. Kolo gets
stabbed.
He's got no trinket.
Oh my
God. Change My Mind has done it. A beautiful all-in, beautiful crowd control.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.